the auto show in Chicago, Illinois, the 2008 auto show. In fact, this is a very significant day in Chicago because this is the 100th anniversary of the auto show. In fact, this auto show is the longest going auto show in the history of the automobile. You know what? America and the Midwest were the birthplace of the automobile. Unbelievable automobiles from the past. We have a display here from the Gilmore Auto Museum in Hickory Corners, Michigan. We've been out there before. We're going to go out there again this year and do a show around what they have. But they have a great display, and we're taking you through a little piece of history in the automobile world. In fact, this auto show started out years ago at the amphitheater. Not only is the automobile the birthplace in America in the Midwest, but also it has such a rich history in Michigan, Detroit, Indiana. And you know what? The first auto race ever held in the history of automobiles was on Lakeshore Drive in Chicago. Great history, great display here from the Gilmore Auto Museum. We have a lot of memorabilia on the walls, from Walter Payton to ex-presidents, old presidents, a lot of concept cars. What a gorgeous display from the Gilmore Auto Museum. But you know what, folks? This is the last time we're going to talk about the past. In today's show, we are going to talk about the future. What's new in the industry? Gas mileage, the sophistication of vehicles, the racing industry. We're going to cover all the cool stuff. But you know what? When I see a display like this, it just warms my heart. I'm like a kid in a candy store. They have some of the rarest cars in the world at the Gilmore Auto Museum, and this display is just gorgeous. General Motors and Chevrolet, pickup trucks, Suburbans, and Tahoes. General Motors has the vehicle for you that gets great gas mileage. They're rated very high in safety standards. They really are comfortable vehicles to drive. General Motors is leading in hybrid vehicles. The Tahoe is a hybrid vehicle. You can buy an option and get a Tahoe, a Chevy Tahoe, in a hybrid. These vehicles are getting 21 miles to the gallon in the city and 22 miles to the gallon on the highway. We also have the Malibu. This year, Chevrolet has come out with a completely brand new Malibu. I love the way it looks. They finally put a little sex appeal in the Malibu, but it also is a hybrid vehicle that gets great gas mileage and very roomy inside for someone that's tall like me. General Motors is a leader in the industry. They have more vehicles that they manufacture get over 30 miles per gallon than any other manufacturer. The Malibu gets anywhere from 21 miles to the gallon to 31 miles to the gallon of gasoline.
Chevrolet Corvette, the ZR1, made in the factory. This is a supercharged automobile, over 620 horsepower V8 engine. You are capable of doing over 200 miles per hour with this automobile. The technology is just phenomenal of what General Motors did with this Corvette ZR1. It's going to be coming out in the late summer of 2008. There'll be 2009 models coming out. They are just phenomenal. What can I say about this automobile? We took a good look at it at the Chicago Auto Show, and what a phenomenal automobile. Carbon fiber throughout on the interior and exterior of the automobile. If anybody knows anything about carbon fiber, they know it's very strong. Leather wrapped interior, it's just so plush, so elegant. Unbelievable look to this Corvette. A lot of chrome features on the wheels. The braking systems are just out of this world. The Corvette braking systems have to be cutting edge technology because this automobile will do in excess of 200 miles per hour. GM has never left a stone unturned when it comes to technology, elegance, class, and I'll tell you what, it's one of the sexiest automobiles on the road today. The Corvette ZR1 for 2008. If nothing else, you should go to your dealerships and check it out. They're going to be starting at around $100,000. But you know what? They compete with automobiles that are made that are costing in excess of $500,000. Chevrolet Corvette, the ZR1.
2008 Corvette convertible. Just a regular basic Corvette. In fact, these are really interesting because you can buy an American Revolution, a true American sports car, for $46,000. That's right, folks, a Corvette convertible. This is the highest technology of automobiles made in America. In fact, the transmission's not mounted on the front of the vehicle anymore. It's not mounted on the engine, it's in the rear of the car. This transfers the weight evenly. I believe we're around 52% of the weight on the front end of the car and 48% on the back end of the car. Makes this vehicle handle a lot better.
If you'd like to advertise on the Chicago History and Automotive Heaven television and radio show, you can contact me at 312-841-2560. Email me at rautomd@gmail.com. Go to our website and check out all of our stuff. We have a sponsors page on there at richiez.com. That's www.richiezie.com. If you have a business, product, or a service, we can put together a package that'll help benefit your business, product, or service. Or if you'd just like to donate, it's a pledge drive. You can donate to our show and keep us on the air. We're actually looking for sponsors to do a lot more shows like you've seen today. I'm Richie Z. Thank you for watching.
2008 Corvette, a coupe. You know, one thing I want to mention about Corvette, not only are they cutting-edge technology when it comes to an automobile, you can get them in every cool color. One of the really neat things I love about Corvette is they always have the sportiest colors on the market. How can you not say the yellow color here isn't sporty? I love the new copper color they came out with a few years ago. It just makes the Corvette look very elegant. And then the blue that they put on the new ZR1 is just phenomenal. Top in technology, top in speed, top in performance, and you even get the luxury ride that you don't expect in a sports car. Chevrolet Corvette. I've been driving one since 1972. You should get one too. Chicago Auto Show, 100 year anniversary. Over $5 billion worth of automobiles on the floor. It's one of the largest auto shows in the world. Pontiac has always been a cutting edge in the industry. This Pontiac convertible is just gorgeous. I mean, this is what America loves. They brought back sex appeal to a sports car. Really a cool concept. But Pontiac also makes great vehicles for the everyday use. And they've really snazzied them up. They really look sharp and they're efficient. You know, GM has over 30 vehicles that get over 30 miles to the gallon, more than any other manufacturer.
If you'd like to advertise on the Chicago History and Automotive Heaven television and radio show, you can contact me at 312-841-2560. Email me at rautomd@gmail.com. Go to our website and check out all of our stuff. We have a sponsors page on there at richiez.com. That's www.richiezie.com. If you have a business, product, or a service, we can put together a package that'll help
benefit your business, product, or service. Or if you'd just like to donate, it's a pledge drive. You can donate to our show and keep us on the air. We're actually looking for sponsors to do a lot more shows like you've seen today. I'm Richie Z. Thank you for watching.
Wild World Classics can't go past a booth like this. We got our armed forces here. You know what? We have one of the vehicles that they use in the war. Can you tell me a little bit about this vehicle?
Yes, sir. This is the M3A3 Bradley Fighting Vehicle. It weighs 19,500 pounds and 22,000 pounds when it's fully combat ready. It's used for mountain warfare in Iraq, and it's an excellent vehicle for urban combat. And Specialist Mahill here can tell you a little bit about the guns on the vehicle.
It carries a 25-millimeter chain gun, has tow capacities for disabling tanks, and also has a laser rangefinder to lock on targets.
You know what? One thing I want to do is mention that the Wild World of Classics doesn't just do cars, motorcycles, and toys, but we actually do other things also. Last year, I went out and filmed the Freedom Run. And the Freedom Run is a motorcycle group. We had over 30,000 motorcycles, and they built a wall for the lost veterans of the Iraq War. It's in Marseilles, Illinois. It was one of the most heart-wrenching experiences I filmed since I've been filming television shows in the last 17 years. And I would just like to thank you guys for keeping us safe and your service to our country. This is an international pickup truck. I think this is the ultimate pickup truck. I think it's one of the largest pickup trucks made in existence. And they use this in the military a lot also. International Harvester has been around for a long time, making tractors and trucks. And this is a real gorgeous looking pickup truck. You know, and this year we're doing a lot of new things with the Wild World of Classics television show. We're going to feature a lot more of these foreign cars. In fact, this one here is the Subaru Impreza. This vehicle here is in excess of 300 horsepower, and it still gets 17 to over 22 miles to the gallon. Unbelievable. But we're going to cover a lot of these cars out of the foreign market. In fact, we did I went to a show, we didn't bring the camera, but there was a few cars from the foreign market that were getting in excess of 800 horsepower with six-cylinder engines. I'm really excited about the generation of automobiles we have now. In fact, let me tell you a little bit of history. In the last 5 years in the automobile industry worldwide, there has been more changes to the automobile, more technical, high performance, safety changes to the automobile than there has since the beginning of the automobile. This is a great time to have a show like mine and do stuff on interesting vehicles like this, a 300 horsepower Subaru Impreza. This Suzuki XL7 is a real cool SUV. In fact, I call this a SUV with sex appeal, but the technology is phenomenal. In fact, we did a test drive and review of this vehicle. We had it for about a week, and I had it under some of the worst conditions in the Chicago area. This winter, we've had a lot of snow, cold, and ice, and this vehicle performed very well. It's a family-friendly vehicle, too. I love the concept of having the roof line higher, because as you can see, I'm 6'1", and I have a hard time getting in and out of some of the vehicles. With this car, during the cold weather, I was able to get in and out of this vehicle comfortably with a fedora on. Real gorgeous car, like I say, sex appeal beyond belief, and real economical. It was getting great gas mileage, and inside friendly also. This vehicle here will seat up to 8 people comfortably.
great car. They start at around $19,000 and go as high as $29,000. For $29,000, you get all the bells and whistles. Global positioning system, sunroof, leather interior, and every feature that you can imagine or want. Suzuki makes a lot of vehicles that are very, very good on gas mileage, economy, and safety. This SX4 Sport gets anywhere from 22 miles in the city to over 30 miles to the gallon on the expressway. You know what? We're going to give you a quick driving tip. If you want to save money on gas mileage, keep the foot out of the pedal. If you do the jackrabbit starts, you'll burn a lot more gas. So if you drive a little more conservatively, you'll get better gas mileage. And this vehicle here starts at around $15,000. Suzuki Hayabusa. This is where it all started. Sport bikes really took a turn for popularity with the Suzuki Hayabusa. Since they made this about, I believe it's about 11 or 12 years ago, it's outsold any other sport bike in the industry. It's the fastest bike in the industry. It's the most technically designed bike in the industry. Great for racing. Just a great all-around performance motorcycle, the Hayabusa. Saab has a great history. Very high technical automobile, great gas mileage, but it has a very high safety rating. In fact, Saab is one of the best safety ratings out. Saab is now owned by General Motors. They make some of the most gorgeous convertibles, and these things are great as far as gas mileage, maneuverability, and speed. Great car, Saab. Hummer is owned by General Motors. These are great vehicles, all around, all terrain vehicle. A lot of guys in construction sites where they have to go in and out of locations, they buy a Hummer because they can get through anything with it. In fact, the military uses Hummers and they have equipped these things to be armor proof. I mean, it's unbelievable what they have done with these vehicles, and they'll go through the desert or go through Alaska, anywhere like that. America makes some of the greatest trucks on the market right now, some of the greatest trucks for the military. Hummer. Hyundai Hope on Wheels, helping kids fight cancer. Hyundai is one of the proud sponsors that raises money to help kids fight cancer. I got to give them a hand too. Hyundai concept car. This coupe is gorgeous with the orange color. It's got a pearlescent tinge to it. It's got a overall length of 183 inches. It's got over 300 horsepower, more than 250 pound torque in it. Six-speed transmission. This vehicle is ready to hit the Autobahn and put the pedal down. What a gorgeous automobile. What a gorgeous concept car by Hyundai. Don't be surprised, folks, if in the next year or two, you see this one in the dealership and you'll be able to buy one too. Hyundai Elantra is another economical car, and I believe it's a gorgeous looking car. Hyundai is another automaker that makes cars with sex appeal, but it's a five-door compact, and it gets great gas mileage, and it's very good on the environment. This vehicle here has got high safety standards also. This Hyundai Elantra was custom painted by Kyle K. Daddy Cruz out of Bakersfield, California. The paint job is spectacular. They've done a lot of things to really brighten this car up but also make it faster. This is a vehicle that they bring to a car show like this, the 100 Auto Show in Chicago, to get enthusiasm into their booth. And believe you me, I've been coming to these car shows for a long time. When I see something like this in a booth, I always stop and I always get interested in some of the other vehicles. Honda makes some real inexpensive cars, but they're real high technology. They make some gorgeous looking automobiles. Hyundai Veracruz. This is another one of those SUVs. They call them crossover vehicles. This vehicle is very good on gas mileage. In fact, we drove one of these for test drive and review, and I gotta tell you, this car has some great horsepower, really gets up and goes. Traction control, which is fantastic. It's It's got airbags on the sides and in the front. Really a great vehicle. But you know why I stopped here? This vehicle here is going to be auctioned off tonight. This is the night of the opening night at the auto show. It's a charity benefit. 13 charities benefit from this night at the auto show. Tickets are $225. It's a black tie event. 13 charities benefit, but they're also giving away three cars, and this is one of the cars they're giving away, a Hyundai Veracruz. This is gorgeous. This is another concept car by Hyundai. This is called an iBlue. This car here is just gorgeous. You know what? I have a deep history in the automotive field, and I'm gonna tell you a little bit about concept cars. You know, a lot of times they'll take things from the hot rod industry, the sporting industry, the customizers, and put them into vehicles like this. But in the same respect, the customizer and the hot rod guys will take something from a concept car like this, and they'll turn that into a vehicle that we're driving today. The all-new 2009 Hyundai Genesis. This is a gorgeous automobile. It is a symbol of power, a fresh life, a new beginning. This V8 engine has over 375 horsepower, 6-speed automatic transmission, 0 to 60 in 6 seconds. Front wheel drive. This car is just gorgeous. The all-new Cadillac CTS-V for 09. This vehicle is the epitome of speed, comfort, and maneuverability. This vehicle has in excess of 550 horsepower. Cadillac's always been a leader in high performance engines. In the 50s, they had a lot of high performance engines. Now, they built this gorgeous CTS-V. 2009 is when this vehicle will be coming out. Cadillac STS, very interesting automobile. This is a V6 that gets anywhere from 26 to 31 miles to the gallon. What did I say earlier? General Motors has more vehicles that get over 30 miles to the gallon than any other manufacturer. Cadillac Escalade, a hybrid vehicle. You know what? General Motors has always worked very hard on trying to get better gas mileage. This vehicle here, being a hybrid in the city, gets double the gas mileage. I love what Cadillac does with their displays. They have a lot of cars. They'll have a lot of concept cars here. It's really a gorgeous display. But here's something that I find real interesting. In fact, I was looking at these things. I was thinking they were models or that. But they are kind of a model of a car, a mock-up of a car. But now you are able, in this display here, pick the color, the wood grain design, and the leather interior that you would like for your automobile. This is a gorgeous display and a gorgeous concept. I think Cadillac went back to giving you what you really want, a car that you could personalize. Bridgestone Tires. Bridgestone Tire Company is really developing some interesting tires. In fact, we put some of them on my vehicles, and I just really, really love the performance, stopping power in the rain, in the snow, and in the ice. But here's a new concept that they're working on. It's not out yet, but this is a tire that they're trying to design right now. In fact, it's in the designing stages. It's got cooling fins on the side of the tire, which will keep the tire cooler. The sidewall is what always heats up on the tires the most, takes the most abuse. By putting a cooling fin in the tire, you'll get a lot better wear and a lot better inflation on a consistent basis. Now we get into run flat technology. This has been around since the 80s, but really hasn't been perfected. Bridgestone stepped up to the plate and perfected this technology. In fact, I got to tell you something. These tires are being sold to BMWs, Porsches, Corvettes, luxury sports cars, and a lot of other sports car manufacturers. You can actually run the tire flat. I love that technology because if you get in trouble, who wants to get out and change the flat tire? Bridgestone has been around for a long time, and a lot of the vehicles on the racetrack are using Bridgestone tires. That tells me something. It tells me how good they grab on the road and how safe they are. Because if you could do over 200 miles an hour on the track and go around 200 laps with a Bridgestone tire, that tells me it's a tire I may want on my vehicle.
If you'd like to advertise on the Chicago History and Automotive Heaven television and radio show, you can contact me at 312-841-2560. Email me at rautomd@gmail.com. Go to our website and check out all of our stuff. We have a sponsors page on there. At richiez.com. That's www.richiezie.com. If you have a business, product, or a service, we can put together a package that'll help benefit your business, product, or service. Or if you just like to donate, it's a pledge drive. You can donate to our show and keep us on the air. We're actually looking for sponsors to do a lot more shows like you've seen today. I'm Richie Z. Thank you for watching.
This year on the Wild World of Classics, we're going to be doing a number of new segments. In fact, one of the viewers' favorite segments is Rich's Tips. We give you tips on how to maintain your automobile, but we also have been working on how to get you more miles per gallon with your automobile. In fact, if you go to our website, www.hlitv.com, there's a list of how to get anywhere from 2 to 5 gallons per tank full out of your automobile. Get 2 to 5 gallons of gas more per tank full out of your automobile. We're also working on a segment called Wild World of Classics Takes the Mystery Out of Automotive History. We're working on Corvette. This is a gorgeous automobile, always has been, always will be an icon in the industry. Corvette is just unbelievable technology. We went down to Bowling Green, Kentucky, filmed at the Corvette Museum. Every year they have a Corvette show. It's called Bloomington Gold. This year and for the last 10 years, it's been at Pheasant Run in St. Charles, Illinois. What a gorgeous Corvette show. It's probably the largest one in the world. If you bring your Corvette to the show, you're able to park it on the golf course. But if you're an automobile enthusiast, I want you to go down there and just check it out. Gorgeous automobiles parked on the golf course. What a picturesque setting. In fact, a lot of you bring cameras and take pictures of these gorgeous cars out there. We're also working on the Mustang, another icon in the industry. I've been around to a lot of auto shows. I probably asked a couple of hundred people that own Mustangs, who made Mustang? And most people can't answer that question. They don't have a clue of who was the guy that had the idea for the Mustang. Keep watching the Wild World of Classics. We're going to be doing a number of real cool segments. In fact, we're working on something called Junkyard Dog to Showtime.